Shopping bots. What are they? How do they work? And how can we beat them? So what are shopping bots? Shopping bots, or retail bots, are advanced pieces of software designed to give people a competitive advantage while shopping online. Bots do this with techniques like scraping price details from across the web, making lightning-fast purchases, and creating fake accounts in bulk. Shopping bots are one of the main reasons it's so hard to get your hands on hype products like sneakers, gaming consoles, and graphics cards. Retail bots even target holiday season sales, earning themselves the name Grinch bots by stealing presents out of the hands of desperate parents. These bots let resellers exploit the mismatch between supply and demand, making millions in the process. And bots are on the rise. They now account for around 40% of all retail traffic. In a recent high-profile sneaker drop we worked with, 97% of the 1.7 million attempted site visits came from bots. So how do shopping bots work? The two key methods of attack bots use are speed and volume. Speed lets bots check out faster. Super speedy scalping bots constantly refresh pages, clicking add to cart the second a product becomes available. These bots autofill information and execute purchases in a flash, snatching products before a regular person can even enter their email address. Volume, on the other hand, lets bots get more inventory. Resellers use bots and proxies to generate hundreds or thousands of fake accounts. This improves their chances during things like sneaker raffles. Plus, it lets them get around purchase limits companies usually put on high-demand products. With volume, max 2 products per customer becomes max 2 products per bot, which means with 1,000 bots, a reseller can snatch up 2,000 products. This dangerous combination of speed and volume gives bots a massive advantage during hype sales and drops. If shoppers were athletes, using a shopping bot would be the equivalent of doping. They make online shopping extremely unfair. So who's using bots and what do they want? Bots are sometimes used by genuine customers, desperate to get their hands on a product for personal use. More often, bots are operated by resellers looking to make a quick buck. And these aren't just clever individuals reselling products on eBay or StockX. Reselling retail goods is a multi-billion dollar industry, with whole outfitted companies with staff in the hundreds. Wherever there's money to be made flipping goods, these bots follow. They target the hottest Christmas toys, the latest sneakers, even essential goods like baby formula and vaccines. They constantly scan the web for products where demand outweighs supply, jumping at opportunities like the supply chain crisis, the pandemic, or the holiday season. The sneaker resale market alone is valued at $10 billion, and next-gen gaming consoles like the PS5 have generated over $200 million in sales on the secondary market. Retail bots are big business, and despite their unfair exploitation of retailers and shoppers, there's currently no laws prohibiting their use. So how do we beat bad bots? Many major retailers are already waging a war against bots. And a key strategy in this war is creating customer and brand relationships through loyalty and membership programs. These relationships help companies distinguish real customers from bots. Companies like Walmart and Target, for example, run early access sales and product drops exclusively for paying members. They tackle the volume problem with bots by making them pay to play. And if you want a high-demand, low-supply product from Amazon, you need to request an invitation. Only vetted, legitimate accounts will be invited to purchase, and these purchases are typically limited to one per verified customer. If you're a shopper, you should take advantage of these loyalty and membership programs. Make yourself known to brands. Show you're a committed customer, not a rotten reseller. And if you still feel these companies aren't doing enough, tell them. Make your voice heard. Use social media to apply pressure and motivate them to take a stronger stance against bots. Pressure from customers drove Nike's strong stance against bots in recent years, and the implementation of fairer sales strategies like virtual waiting rooms and invite-only sales at Walmart, Amazon, and Sony. If you're a retailer, you need to listen to these calls for fairness and ramp up bot mitigation efforts with tactics and tools like detailed traffic monitoring, post-sale audits, bot mitigation software, virtual waiting rooms, and exclusive invite-only sales for known genuine users. Bad bots aren't just bad for customers. They don't only make sales unfair. They also break down trust and loyalty, drive up operational support and cloud computing costs, create faulty analytics for decision-making, and crash and slow down websites. That's why major companies from Nike to Sony to Amazon are taking steps to block bots. Because as these major retail players know, the fight against bots is a fight for your customers, your brand, and your bottom line. So if you've enjoyed this video, check out the other videos in our Quick Questions with Kewitt series, or head to kewitt.com for more content like this.